Hey there guys, this is Basinger 313 here with a continuation of the Super Mario Maker Let's Play. And if you've been following me on Miiverse, you know how really pretty much I've been making a whole lot of levels. Here, let me showcase most of them, whatever. How do I do that again? Shit. Core spot, there we go. So I made specifically three levels, and I guess for this part I just want to showcase the all three of them. I made a fourth level, but that one sucks. So you guys know Pathway Judgment, but there's also three more, which you already can see it in World 2. So, yeah. Starting off with Ninja Gaiden Act 1-1. If you guys played the NES Ninja Gaiden game, you know what this is. I hope. I'm gonna try to recreate as much as possible to the what the original game was. Like, there were these enemies that I went back and forth, so that kind of reminded me of like the Red Koopa, the Koopa Kings. And there should be a dog, yep, and of course that has to be a Chain Chomp, because why the hell not? How do I? I forgot how to, I think I had to be big in order to do that. Oh yeah, there's these doors here, but they don't leave anywhere, as you can tell. They were just purely for aesthetics, but I just made it there because there's like a, kind of like a shop in the area, but you can't, it's basically inaccessible, so I just decided to stay right there because it looked cool. And yeah, there are more stops there. Again, there's the door thing. Now these things are the hidden blocks. They're based off of the items you get when you slash those, like kind of like the candles in Castlevania. I tried to keep them in tune to what the game power up were. Sometimes they just give you points. Sometimes they give you ammunition for special weapons. But I don't know exactly how I implement that. So I just decided to shove off coins instead and just give you extra points basically. There are some like and yeah, most of the power-ups, no, all the powers are basically in the sync with what power they give you. Like there's, well, the fire power obviously, but I think that's like the only power-up I gave, because there, like, some of the power-ups like Ninja Gaiden showed you did not, did not include like fire-based attacks. Then most of them were, but most of them don't. And here we have the first boss battle, and of course it's Bowser. Of course you can't really like slash him or anything. You can try and kill him with the fire flower, but because I don't have it, I'm just gonna jump over him. And there we go. That's the level right there. I have no idea how to transition from the boss battle into whatever, so I decided to just put the warp pipe there, because there's no way you could like beat the boss battle and let the stage end like that. It doesn't have that much creative freedom. Next up, we got Smiles and Tears Prototype. Now, originally I wanted to make this like kind of like an auto level, but I have no idea how to do that. So instead, I just like, oh fuck, I'll just make the notes here. And if you guys know Earthbound, you know what Smiles and Tears is. I'm gonna shut up for here for a moment, for this entire level. Hopefully I pass this in one go, and tell me if you don't recognize this tune. Oh shit. Well, of course I had to actually do it well, so as well. So far no one has actually passed this stage, surprisingly. I figured this was probably like the second easiest level I've made. Well, published at least. Anyways, so oops. Alright, let me shut up again. So you guys definitely can tell it's definitely not in rhythm or in melody, but I just got the notes down, that's about it. And you just have to platform your way to those music notes, and yeah, you don't have to necessarily play entire melody, for instance. You could skip that two of them and just skip to there. But you get the idea as to what the notes indicate, right? I'm gonna try and play all the melodies if I can. If I can, of course. That jump is really tight. Since you're not really running or anything, but I think it does change your momentum, so I do it either way. Just in case. And yeah, the heartbeat sound effect was there to make sure the notes are hearable, basically. Oh, come on! I was so close to the end! Ugh, okay. Let's try this again. I'm not going until I pass this stage. What the hell?
Oh, Mama! Oh, Mario!
What the fuck? What the f- Okay, this has not happened to me before. Is there like a- What the fuck was that? Okay, that happened. I don't know how I initiated that, but that something happened like that, I guess. That never happened to me before. I don't know what requirements for that special game over screen to initiate, but that was a thing. Sounded like Mario was getting orgy fucked over a bunch of different Marios. And Peach just surprised out of her ass, like, noticing the orgy. Smiles and tears, ladies and gentlemen! Shit. Well, so far I've been nothing but tears because of my death. Alright. I can see why this is hard, but with enough practice, I'm pretty sure you can get by it. I've seen people beat this stage before, especially when I was going to my college's game club. People have beaten this stage before, so it's definitely possible, so I'm not sure why it's still like a 0 out of whatever rating. Because no one has yet to beat the stage, surprisingly. And of course, this was before I found out about the whole, TV, static sound effect that you can implement. So, I was sticking to the heartbeat. I might update that later. Because the heartbeat can, pretty much screw over the song, of course. And there we go. Ta-da! Yeah. Alright now, but that's not what we're here to talk about. Oh, that is part of the reason why we were talking about the creative levels that I've made throughout the past. What? Did I make that level? September 14th. This! Now, if you want a level that's true balls to the walls, near impossible, because... I mean, I think it's because no one has really played this game, this level as much, but I really want to showcase this level so badly because I worked very hard on it, and you'll see why. Because this level is quite, this is definitely the hardest level I have created in Mario Maker. First off, it has these two boos in which if you have no idea how to get past them, then you're fucked. I do know. I do though, so I'm able to pass through it. Not done yet, we got these Goombas, and surprisingly, when I was, in my, video game club, this was the part in which a lot of people kinda, like, died over, because for some reason, I think the Goombas were, like, too tiny, and the, screen was really tiny, so, the space you were in wasn't good enough for you to, really try and, yeah. But yeah, with a lot of practice, you can pretty much get through this. Alright. Get over here, we got a mushroom. This mushroom's required, by the way, so you can break these blocks. There's no other way you can break these blocks, from my knowledge, I think. Do not break these blocks, otherwise you're fucked. Jump! So yeah, follow the arrow. Trust in the arrows, literally. Now you jump into these Koopas, and fuck. But yeah, if you notice, I think you know how to exactly, get past that area. You need to jump onto the Koopa and into the warp pipe. That is surprisingly really tight spacing right there, and you'll see why, because I feel like aside from the final area, that was the hardest part I had to deal with. And yeah, there's definitely some sort of spikes later on. Like, it does get easier from here up until the last battle, and you'll see why. And if you're already interested in this level, hold on. I should show you the IDs before, playing these levels, huh? Hold on a minute. Course World. It should, three of those levels are already uploaded to Miiverse. So you guys should be able to download it, assuming that Nintendo doesn't fuck up with my levels or anything. So, Ninja Gaiden Act. Hurry up. There's your ID, D7040000. The O's are zeros, by the way. They're not actual zeros. So, D7040000003800D6F. It has a 15% completion rate, but honestly, I think that this level is pretty easy. So, it should be a lot higher, honestly. Next up, where is it? Smiles and Tears. Again, 0% clear rate. How many people attempted it? 55 people attempted it. Surprisingly, no one has passed it yet. That's pretty weird. This one is legitimately 0% because it is pretty fucking hard, and it is 42. There are 42 attempts, so there's less attempts than Smiles and Tears, but honestly, Smiles and Tears shouldn't take that much time to, try and, beat. Oh, like, I could just play the levels from here, right? Yeah, let's try that. Alright. So yeah, trust in the arrows, trust me. That's basically the key, level as to how to, deal with this level. The arrows definitely do point you along the way. And I know what you're thinking. Oh, is there a wave? Is there gonna be another? Is there something that's gonna troll us or something? Like, we do follow the arrows, but that's just gonna lead us to death? No, there is not. I will tell you that straightforward right there. No arrows will lead to death. And trust me on that. Or should you? but yeah. So yeah. The arrow's pointing down there. There's a platform there. And the arrow's right there is pointing that way, so that means you need to get a running start. Koopa. Damn it! Yeah, the timing is, you have to be in the middle. You can't be in, like, slightly to the left or slightly to the right. No, it has to be pitch perfect in the middle. Otherwise, it's just oog. God damn, it's hard. Yeah, I have not been able to, beat this level consistently. Is the color saturation a little bit weird in my on the recording, because for some reason it's a lot more brighter when I record things. Yeah, you do need the three blocks. I think you need three blocks in order to fully jump. Like, they are right there. It looks kind of purple pinkish, and when I'm looking at my gamepad, it looks kind of really pinkish. Oops. Yeah, it looks really pinkish from my gamepad screen, but it looks really purplish in my my TV screen. So I'm not sure if that's... The same thing goes for the Boo's mouth. Like, this one looks really purple on my screen, but red on your on the gamepad. And I'm not sure if the recording's gonna show up a little bit off. But, I don't know. I'm not sure how exactly I could fix the color or saturation whatsoever. So, unless someone gives me an answer, this is what you're gonna be seeing for a while. Assuming that you guys are seeing the same thing I'm seeing. I'm not sure, though. Alright. Weep. Alright. There we go. So yeah, it's definitely possible. Now, there's an arrow pointing right there. Whoa. Okay, something's happening over there. There's a secret passage. Oh shit, whoa, I forgot about this. Oh my god, I even forgot about my own level design. There's a thwomp that's gonna go down. So yeah, I think that's kind of, by watching this video, you're kind of ruining the surprises. Now, there are two areas you can go. You can either have to go left, not left. You can have to go up, or you could go down. And, oh shit, let's go up. I feel like that might be a little bit harder. Yeah. Giant's tricky. That warp pipe right there, you can actually go through it, but, let's demonstrate it. I don't mind doing a lot of retries. Let's demonstrate what happens if you go to that warp pipe. Because, look, the arrow says to go up here, not onto this warp pipe. So what happens if you don't trust in the arrows? Oh shit, there's a time limit too, holy shit. That's what happens. So yeah, really trust in those goddamn arrows, otherwise you're fucked. So that's what I mean when I say trust in the arrows, because if you do not trust in the arrows, you will die. Period. In fact, hold on. I'm gonna cheat a little bit. I'm gonna go into this shortcut right here. Yeah, there's a secret shortcut right here. So, the arrow's pointing up there, right? What happens if you go down this dwarf pipe? Leads to death, once again. So, yeah, again, trust in the fucking arrows. But yeah, you notice how there's another arrow that's stating to go up to the right? Where does that lead to exactly? Well, once we get to that, you'll find out. There's another warp pipe. Where does this lead to? This area where that arrow says go that way, even though, yeah, you can only see, like, blue buzzy beetles, right? What happens if we go this way? Oh, nothing. Hey, isn't this the same area? Yeah! So yeah, all the areas are definitely connected. Notice how the Koopa and the warp pipes are the same areas that we've been through before. I'm not gonna go there. I'm not gonna continue going onto that shortcut just yet. I want to showcase the intricacies of the level. Oops. Shit. I'm guessing this is where the majority of people died in this level, is this simple little boo room. Yeah, it's not that hard once you get into the rhythm and the timing of the area. So let's go down here. Hopefully I could get back to where I was before. God, I really love the music in this game. Hopefully I don't get copyright infringements though. But hey, this is Nintendo, of course they will. So it doesn't really matter much if I don't talk or not. Over here. And I forgot to press the jump button. Derpity derp. Alright. This shouldn't take too long! Alright. Actually, I am curious. What does the boo look like on your recording screen? Because it's definitely, like, very purple on my screen. Oh, it's pretty pink on your screen, so you guys should be viewing this normally. But, I, for some reason, am not. Okay. There we go. This is probably the longest level I've made as well. Like, with Ninja Gaiden, it's pretty fast, and despite having like 500 seconds on whatchamacallit, on Smiles and Tears, this one is Smiles and Tears was relatively quick. Damn it! But yeah, I think this game, depending on whether or not you take the normal route or the shortcut route, has three different stages. Oh shit. No, sorry, not three. Four or five different stages. The fifth one being the final area. And if you take the secret route, I think you skip two separate areas. But again, I think it gets harder when you get to that area, the shortcut area. So be careful when you do take the shortcut area, because it does get much harder when you do that. I recommend going to this area as a beginner's pathway, but if you do want to take the shortcut, be my guest. There we go, alright. Speaking of shortcuts, there's also another shortcut. Notice that arrow right there that's pointing up? And see, notice these blocks, and the fact that there's a mushroom here? What if you break them? Oh shit, you can go through these blocks. Of course, you have to be careful about the bullet bills. Oh hey, look! They're the bull boos again! Now, where does this lead to? The springing jumps with these claptrap looking things. Now, how do we get over there? Well, what's over here? Oh, just another coin block? Okay, nothing real. Another coin block, okay. Oh, hey, a feather! Alright, so let's use this feather, and what do? We jump over them, right? Yeah, let's jump over them. And, oh shit, there's a... Oh, huh. Okay, you killed the chain jump. I actually didn't expect that, because I used to chain jump nearly because the chain jump somehow, like, goes through this wall and attacks you after you go after this thwomp. So at least you to this warp pipe, and there's also a door leading to there. However, thing is, the arrows are pointing that way and not in the door or the warp pipe. So let's see what happens if we go into this warp pipe. Oh shit, death! But no, you can still save yourself in case. Oh fuck, it's still possible to save yourself at least though. But where does this door lead to? This area. Are you trapped? Oh no, you're not trapped. It just has to be very precise jumping. Oh shit, no. Oh fuck. Oh, I don't know. I think I can respawn the arrow. Maybe. Oh shit. See, the thing is, you're supposed to go into this warp pipe. This is kind of like the legitimate way to go to the warp pipe here. But I forgot where that warp pipe leads to. And the point is, you're supposed to like be tiny, hit that block, and get the feather. The problem is, I was big, so I was really unable to least do that in time. And the point was to, of course, fly. And it says they're up there. Okay, see that? Hold right. So basically, you have to fly over the area. But because we don't have the thing, we're dead. It doesn't matter anyways. I had 30 seconds left on the time. So the timer, by the way, you have 180 seconds. That's basically 3 minutes to pass this stage. Doing that will make things a lot more harder to, because you're kind of forced to speed run through this game a little bit due to how short the time limit is. Hopefully I can do that. I beat this game, this stage once, and I was so glad that I beat it. Actually, hold on. Let me test if you can actually do it with the second block. Oh shit, you can, so... Yeah, so that... You don't need the first one! Shit. At all. So that's one way to speed run through it. Ignore the... Just hit the first one, jump over it, and then run your life away. Hit! Okay. Yeah, the best way to deal with this level is to not panic under pressure. I think that's... Oh, fuck. I think that's the number one way to really, like, deal with the hardships of this level. Okay. Come on. Yeah, I feel like that warp pipe is definitely the hardest part, trying to jump up the Koopas. And yeah, I know this video is probably going to be long, and I should have made it this segment as its own standalone segment because of how expansive this level is specifically. But hey, I'm kind of rushing through things! And I think it's totally fine. Because the next time, next part, I'm not sure what exactly I'm gonna do. I'm gonna probably either deal with the 100 Mario challenge, I really want to try that out, since I recently unlocked expert mode, or I probably want to make my own level again and try to make like a very hard level. Okay. So out of curiosity, oh shit, oh no, oh no, okay, this is not what I want, fuck, oh man, so yeah, I really mistimed the whole jump there, and unfortunately there was no checkpoint, so you're kind of forced to go to the beginning of the level, which really sucks, because, like, I really do want to implement checkpoints, because, like, you shouldn't be punished to go all the way back to the beginning of the level if you've been through, like, a specific part, but for some reason they did implement checkpoints, especially since Super Mario World has, like, a checkpoint, feature with the whole that white line, and it grow big if you go through it and you're still tiny, but unfortunately Super Mario World does not have that feature, at least not yet to my knowledge. Shit, that's a really hard jump to make, trust me, it's a lot harder than it looks, than yeah, what it looks like. Like, oh, I'll just jump onto the Koopa and then go up, right? No, it's, you have to be precise on your jumping, especially if you're not used to Super Mario World's momentum. That's one thing I really like about this game, by the way, is that the way Mario moves and his momentum is, oh fuck, is pretty much in tune and the exact as his Super Mario World, Super Mario Bros. 1, Super Mario Bros. 3 counterpart. So yeah, and Super Mario Bros. U. Although I'm not too familiar with Super Mario Bros. U because I haven't really played that much of that game. So yeah. So getting to this first level should take about 10 seconds if you're really fast. A lot less if you probably like dodge through that those moves a lot quicker. Can I make that jump? Okay, good. There we go. Whew. Yeah, I want to showcase more of the areas there. See what's up. Gotta be careful about the bullet bills. They're pretty easy to dodge if you could handle them. Alright, let's try this one more time. Alright. Bam! Alright, oh, okay, this didn't kill them. Let's go to this door right here. What's there? Oh shit, it's Bowser! If you want to... So, let's say if you don't want to deal with Bowser and how to do this, well, problem is, you're kind of fucked. I mean, you get as many, like, of those as possible, but I don't think you can kill these guys with the feather, so you're kind of forced to deal with Bowser here. So, how do I deal with Bowser here? It's actually kind of simple, actually, to be honest. There's a fire flower there if you want, but let's skip that for now. There's a warp pipe here, and the arrow points to the left, onto this warp pipe. Now we're here in this area. Oh shit, oh fuck, I didn't even notice about that enemy right there. So you're supposed to like, oh shit, ooh, I didn't mean to do that. You're supposed to go into these treadmills, and I think because I have the cape, it's a little bit tougher for me to deal with. But I think in the long run, it's actually going to make it a lot more easier for me to deal with Bowser, actually, now that I think about it. Oh fuck, Hammer Bros. Ooh, that's a close one. So there's these trampolines. It makes platforming a lot more easier as well. Don't mind if I do. So here we are. This is the last area. This is where, oh crap. This is where Bowser is. And let me see if I could get that fire flower. I don't think I can, so. Shit. So, oh fuck, oh shit. Okay, so now I'm pretty much trapped. So how do I deal with this area or predicament? You think, oh, well, let's jump over there, right? But as you can see, I hit a bunch of invisible blocks, and I think that's like my trolliest level out of all. All of those, like, as soon as you jump, you'll hit a hidden block, and you'll be stuck there forever. But how do you beat him? Well, there was the fire flower, so you could use that to kill the Bowser. But how do I beat the level? Well, you see once we, deal with the, what deal with Bowser. If I ever actually deal with Bowser, because the way you deal with Bowser is fucking hard and pretty damn precise in order to beat him. Ah, shit. And of course, I'm taking the long way out though, but I will do the shortcut once I explain where that shortcut is. Okay, good. So I think we're done with those two areas, right? No, I didn't showcase the last warp pipe, I don't think. So let's go there. And to get to that warp pipe, hold on a minute, you need the feather, of course. And you need a head start. Alright, so the arrow points out there, right? Can you make that jump? Yes, you can. So, yeah, I made sure you don't- Oh, hey, it's this area again, so now you can properly- I have a proper cape now. So, yeah, area, I made sure, like, you could use the cape thing, hopefully. So, yeah. So now, hold right, and literally, just hold right, because this thing auto-plays. Now it says hold A again. So, hey, there's that area, right? So, here we go. Now we're here. Oh, shit. Oops, I didn't notice there was a piranha plant there, unfortunately, so kind of got screwed there. Okay, let's see if I can make it before the time runs out. Oh shit! Oh crap, Hammer Bros. Oh fuck, now we're tiny! That's pretty bad. Oh, come on, Goomba! Why didn't you- Oh shit. Alright, that's my fault. Alright, so now that we know where that shortcut leads us, let's use the shortcut now to make- for us to save time. No, wait. Before we do that... let's use the shortcut, actually. Because, I remember the warp pipe that leads us to that downstairs area. Actually, now that I think about it, hold on. Oh, never mind, actually. Oh, fuck me. Oh, fuck me, I failed. Alright, let's not use the shortcut just yet, actually. We'll use that once we are dealing with whatever else is on that other warp pipe. Oh, fuck me. Trust me, this is gonna be a one long episode. Oh, in case anyone's wondering about the tornado spin, you cannot spin on the booze. In case anyone's curious, so that's not an option. You have to jump over them somehow. The tornado spin only works with certain enemies. Boos are not one of them. You saw with the Thwomp and the Buzzy Beetles. So far, those are the two enemies I think that are able to you can easily use the tornado spin against. Every other enemy, I don't think so. Well, are there any other enemies besides Goombas and Koopas, obviously? No, I think Chain Chomps also allow you to use a tornado spin on them. Oh, god damn it! Yeah, this level is pretty damn fucking hard. If you guys can't tell, even I'm having a lot of trouble dealing with it. And trust me, it's probably gonna get a lot harder once we try and make another level. I really want to try and make another level, but I want to do this off of improv and see what I've gathered. All right. Awesome. Huh! Like, every single button you clench is like your asshole clenching in sidewards. Oh, that's a close one. Alright, so we don't need to go down this block again. At all, hopefully. But there is this weird, peculiar, stairway right there. How do we get up there? Well, there's a trampoline there, so I'm assuming you could just jump over there. Oh, hey, a hidden block makes things a lot more easier for us to, parkour there, right? So, let's do that. Oh, shit. Of course, I had to somehow get over there. There we go. Oh, crap. Of course, I had to actually make it across as well. There we go. And lead to here. Oh, shit. I better not be careful to jump over there. So, where does this door lead to? Death. Yeah, there's, again, trust in the fucking arrows. Otherwise, you'll lead to death. So, there's a reason why the title literally says trust in the arrows. You'll die if you do not trust in the arrows. I think there's one more area we have yet to, establish. So, let's go there and then we'll take the shortcut if we want. If, I feel the need to. Alright. I know I could also go to the stage creator and shortcut my way there too, but I wanted to be more authentic and say, oh, this part of the area is definitely possible and bypassable, in case anyone's curious. So this is all legit right here. Okay. Say, once you get the patterns, the boost, not that hard. Yeah, a lot of people had a whole lot of troubles trying to deal with the boos on their first run, but as soon as they managed to deal with them, it's all good. Hey! Okay. Oh shit! Oh no! I didn't hold the jump button! Did everyone just die in like the beginning area? Because I'm not seeing a whole lot of X's in them. Any other area besides the boo. 42 people did attempt this, right? Hopefully. Because I really do want this level to be popular, because I've worked so hard on it. Alright. Ah, oh, shit. I don't think I can do that with them. With one block. That's a lot more harder to deal with, I think, so I'm not gonna even bother risking that attempt! Shit. Oh, I see the X! Fuck, okay, so one guy at least did attempt to, go through the warp pipe, but unfortunately died. Ugh. Dealing with these Goombas perfectly fine, at least, so that's good. Dying on Goombas, yeah, that's definitely a bad, painful death. Ah, shit. That's fine. We don't need the mushroom, anyways. We only need the mushroom just to break the blocks. You don't need the mushroom for anything else. Plus, this area. Well, if I make a pass, they'll give you a mushroom either way. I'll give you a mushroom either way because of a hidden block. That's visible, by the way. It's not hidden. In case anyone is worried. Barum. Alright. Yeah, I've been able to train with the entire area, but the final area where you have to defeat Bowser and hit the, axe, I feel like that's definitely gonna be the hardest part for me because I have been able to hit that consistently. Same thing goes for the pipe as well. But trust me, the Bowser area is a lot more harder than the pipe, so you gotta be careful and be prepared. Yeah, I'm awfully quiet now, so obviously Nintendo's gonna flag this for copyrights. Whatever! There we go. Alright. So, yeah, we went through up there, right? And again, there's the mushroom in case you, lost it. So, here we have more warp pipes. These warp pipes don't lead to anywhere, by the way, in case anyone's curious. Now, Yep, there's that swamp, so be careful. The arrow points up, so of course you have to go up. Now, we went to the top path, and we already went to both of them already. So, but there is a secret here. Bomb-omb. And there's a door right here, right? But there are some wooden bricks in the way. Or, not wooden bricks. Blocks in the way. Not wooden. Stone. And it leads to the final boss area. So this is a huge shortcut in case anyone wants to get there. Now, of course, I have to actually get the fire flower, and I couldn't. So yeah, that bomb-omb right there. Huge speed running tactic in case you want to, get to it real quickly and you don't know how to get anywhere, which I already told you the answer, so joke ruined. Unfortunately, you're not trapped, by the way. You clearly saw me jump over the hidden block, although the hammer bro will give you a lot of trouble if you don't escape in time, especially on your first try and blindly. Nice. So we went through up there already. Sorry, the bottom area already. Now let's, go whatever hell's downward. Yeah, this part shouldn't be too hard. There's definitely a lot of buzzsaws. Oh shit. Yeah, if you don't have a mushroom, you're fucked, and that heart beating will surely, mess you up a little bit. What's up here exactly? I don't remember. I don't think it just leads to a dead end, I think. Yeah, it just leads to a dead end. So as you can tell right there, there's Bowser Jr., but the arrow's pointing the right side. How do you get down there? Oh shit, there are some fireballs. Fire bars, sorry. Let's go down there instead and bam. Oh shit. Well, of course. Yeah, the fire bars are gonna give you a lot of trouble, but you can definitely go as fast as possible. And, jump over there. So let's try and do that again and jump up and try and defeat Bowser Jr. Which, trust me, it's fucking hard as hell. Although I do give you, like, extra mushrooms and a Koopa shell. In case you're having some troubles. Whew, okay, I think I'm able to get that consistently, hopefully. Yeah, we're still going to the right this time. These have piranha plants, by the way, but I'm going way too fast, so it doesn't really matter if they show up or not. Oh, there we go. So one of them showed up. Oh crap, is that fire arrow gonna hit me? Oh, nice! Okay. Alright. Now here we have— oh! This also leads to another shortcut if you— well, I managed to fail to do so. And, oh shit, I actually need a mushroom in order to, like, break down here, but because I don't have a mushroom, I guess that doesn't matter. Oh fuck. Avoiding these guys are gonna be really tough. So yeah, the bomb only shows up once, unfortunately. So, yeah, if you messed up, you're kinda screwed. Oh, come on, is there fire? The fucking fire's gonna be gone. In case anyone was wondering, yes, I also made these music notes to have a melody as well. Shit. It's supposed to play a Fur Elise, or at least the first stanza of Fur Elise when you play the notes in order. In case anyone was wondering. I decided to just do that just for fun. I might have more of those music notes later on. Okay, enough fooling around. Hopefully we can get to Bowser Jr. before we get to Bowser. Bowser Jr. is entirely optional, in case anyone's wondering. Of course, I gave you multiple different pathways, including the shortcut, in case you guys really want to, do that. Oh, shit. Okay. What? Oh, fuck, really? I didn't— oh, shit. I wasn't high enough. Shit. Alright, that's fine, that's fine. Run it back, run it back, run it back. Oh, fuck me. Okay. There we go. I have to clench my asshole every time I do that. It just... gotcha! Yeah, you ever had that feeling? Get down here, Thwomp! Got you. Ain't tricking me this time, motherfucker. So, let me see if I can actually play Fur Elise this time. Oh shit, oops. Yeah, it's supposed to play Fur Elise, in case anyone's wondering. Is that enough? Fuck, it's not enough, alright. So, shit. Yeah, it doesn't play upward, though. Alright, well, there are the fireballs right there. Let me just wait until, yeah, they revert. Ah, fuck. That's fine, that's fine. No, that's not fine. Shit. Ugh. Alright. Try that again. We can get to him. Again. My mic's on, right? Whatever, I died. Let me check if my mic's on real quickly. I might have accidentally disabled it as soon as I took off my clothes off, because it is a hot day, surprisingly, still. Of course, it's 42 minutes, but then again, the previous Paper Mario... Sorry, not Paper Mario. Super Mario Maker episodes were not that long. So... Okay. So, make it a lot more quicker as soon as, we showcase all the areas you can go through. Oh crap. Oh that's bot. That's perfect. Alright. Hey! Damn it! Oh yeah, it says hi. Or whatever, I don't know. I tried to make a customization point, but I think I didn't have enough time, and for some reason I left that in the final version. Oh well. Okay. Oh, okay. Can't dash dance in this game, unfortunately. What is it, Smash Bros? Oh no, no, no. Oh my god, fuck! Wow, I pancaked real hard right there. One guy died as soon as he, like, on that bottom area as well. Sorry, dude. Okay. There we go. Come on. Come on! There we go. Alright. Baby Bowser, here we go. Hopefully. Like, I should get to you this time. I'm gonna use the bomb-bomb trick instead, because you can still- Oh, no, 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 fuck! Damn it. You can still get to him, even going under the fire flowers, but again, it's... tight precision jumping. Alright, there we go. Perfect. Blind nicely, too. Alright, here we go. So, here we go. Bowser Jr. Now, there are two ways. Of course, you got the, Koopa Shell as well. And there was a Magic Koopa for some reason. Fuck. So, yeah, you could use the Koopa Shell to, damage if you want to. Mushroom? Come on, Mushroom! On a while, you also have to fucking avoid Bowser's Fireballs of Hell. Okay, Bowser Jr.'s done. I want to go using Mushroom. And there's a door there, by the way, in case anyone's wondering. Alright. So, how do we get down there? Well, first off... Shit. Alright. You need a mushroom. Thank god you have infinite mushrooms spawning here. But god damn it! The fire Yeah, but that door leads to that door, the one that's on top of the warp pipe, in case anyone's wondering. So, you could do that. If you want to. I forgot where that warp pipe leads to, though. Huh. I'm curious now, actually. Oh, now that we're... here... Oh, yeah, I think I know where the warp pipe leads to. Okay, yeah, I showcased all the areas. Now it's time to go to the shortcut this time to make things a lot more faster for us. It is possible to beat the entire level under the time limit, though, so in case anyone's wondering, oh, you it's not possible to beat the level on a certain time limit. No, it's definitely possible. You just have to really work hard at it. Alright. Oh crap. Alright, I still got a Koopa shell. Thank God. I don't want to deal with those hammer bros. So I gave you enough ammunition to... Shit. I gave you guys enough ammunition to deal with those guys, but yeah, regardless, it's still pretty damn hard. If you're not careful enough. So yeah, time to go to Shortcut this time. Finally. How long has it been? Like 40 fucking minutes of this recording session alone? Hut 2. Okay. Oh shit. Alright, one more hammer bro. Oh, that's close one. Let's get rid of this Goomba. I feel like he's gonna really fuck us over. Alright, here we go. Oh no, yeah, I remember where this war pipe leads us to now. Okay. Be careful with the thwomp! Yeah, really be careful with the thwomp. Alright. Now, yeah, you could use the Fire Flower, but if you can't, you can always use the Koopa Shells that are constantly respawning. But if you do that, then you're kind of fucked. Oh, this is perfect! Alright, this is how you get it! Don't jump over there! Get to the axe! You win! So yeah, you need the fucking Koopa Shell in order to, get through those areas. And yeah, if you manage to do that, then you win. Boing, 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 boing. Inside with thee. So yeah, in case anyone's wondering, it is definitely possible to beat this level, despite the 0% ratio. Although now that I beat it, does that add into the, no it doesn't. So yeah, that's the level ID in case you want to try it out, 7DEA00000049349F, in case you guys want to try it out. So yeah. Those are the three levels I made. I do have one more level, which is Welcome to Bulletstorm, but it fucking sucks so much. I just made this off my own time, and I'll publish it because why the fuck not? So, Welcome to Bulletstorm. Basically, what is this level? You got 20 seconds, and it's an auto-scrolling level, but there's a very easy way to beat this level. All you have to do is just repeatedly tap A, and yeah, the enemies will pretty much avoid you at all costs. And there we go. There's the last area. Do-do-do-do. Boing, boing. Oh, that shit hurt, right? Lummy. That's okay, we got a star. Lummy. He says wowie even after all that shenanigans. Yeah, one guy said wild things, that's too easy, all you do is just stay up to top, so yeah, it was a really stupid level that I made, but I just published it anyways. For some reason, it has 2 stars. No, 3 stars! While everything else has 0, 2, 2, and 1. What the fuck is wrong with you guys? The one legitimate level that I actually made gets a 0 star, but whenever I make goofy fucking levels, I get good stars? Well, whatever. So, what should I do? Should I actually make a level, or should I make the 100 Mario challenge? No, let's finish it off with a make it level. So, next part, we're gonna be doing the Super Mario 100 challenge. Except, we're going on expert, ladies and gentlemen, so this is gonna be one real doozy of a level. So, we'll be right back, and stay tuned for the next episode. What the fuck are you doing here, you stupid, stupid fly? God damn it. There was a fly there, sorry. Be right back.